Today we are going to get some rosemary bread. Let's just get some rosemary out of this fresh place. You're bad. You need to go off. No! Ah! Why? Friggin' dog, I hate you. Oh god, dog, why? Oh my god, it's like freaking quicksand. Don't put very much weight on it. Nope. Okay, then I'm not going to be able to get back over there. Oh my god. I need to make a fence. He's killing my time. I hate you, doggy. Why you do this to me? I've been good to you. Collect the rosemary. You can use how much you want, but I just want to like snip some off. There's some more. Now that's how much I like to collect, but you can use as much as you want, okay? Bowls, measuring spoons. Optional if you want to sieve the flour. A sieve. This recipe I'm going to be using, I got it off the internet, so. All you have to do is pour your 1 cup of warm water, 1 tablespoon of dry active yeast, 1 tablespoon. No, it's a spoon. Some kind of dough. Okay, so then you want to get 3/4 of your rosemary. So I have 3 stems here and 1 stem here. So you gotta get these 3 stems of rosemary, peel them from their stems. First you pop off the top and then you pop off the first few leaves. Then you skin it. Start chopping. Man, the grid. Now the rosemary straight into this.
Is that flour?
No, that's sugar. And this is the dough I'm just.
Does it require flour?
Yes, I've already put in 2 cups of it.
Just this kind of flour?
Yes, as far as I know. working out now, so. Then you add some flour onto a cutting board, plastic board, or on just onto any countertop. The 10 minutes that you have to knead this for by hand, it should start to look like bread dough. Now that you have your dough onto your cutting board, just sprinkle some flour on top of it, and then just start to add flour into it like this. Just knead it. Kneading is like just pushing and folding and adding flour into the dough by hand. That's what we're doing right now. Then you come over here, add some more flour, extra flour that you just got around. Fold it, push. Now we have oil in the bowl, we're going to put the dough in this bowl, then put a towel over it. Put the towel over the bowl, and then let it rise in a cool, dry place for 1 hour. In 1 hour, we'll be back, and you'll see. In 1 hour, we'll be back, and the bread will have been raised, and it will rise from the dead. Okay, see you back in an hour. Bye. Okay, so now this dough has sat in a warm, dry place for about an hour, and it has risen to about half the size. Now, what you want to do is, just punch the dough down. It should be very fluffy and airy. Just punch it down, like, hit it. And then you gotta just oil something. Oil the thing that you plan to use as your baking. This thing, let this dough sit for about another 5 minutes or so. It'll be fine. Okay, so yeah. Now you have to grate your dough, and then you gotta put it in the pan. Puppy. And then you gotta get some extra rosemary and just sprinkle it on top. Dough rise again until double for about 45 minutes. I see you got 45 minutes. The bread is halfway through its written process. Bake it for 15 to 20 minutes. flour, however, until it turns a goldenish brown. But remember, you're adding butter when this thing is done. So don't forget that part. So now you got to stick it. For 20 minutes, and then it is a bread. See? Look at it. That's the finished product. Part is bread, I guess. Get the butter. Wash it with the butter. Wash the bread with the butter. Okay, that's the finished product. You got the butter, you got the brush, you got the buttered bread. Nice. So, yep, that's all we need. Just a nice loaf of rosemary bread. Hopefully you followed directions correctly and you didn't screw it up, but I think it's really nice, fresh tasting bread that's got so much rosemary in it, you can see it. Okay, thanks for watching.